Okay, grade 4, welcome to another read aloud. And today we are going to read a folktale from Africa. And the name of the folktale is Honey, Honey, Lion, written by Jan Brett. Here you can see there are so many animals in the forest of Africa. What they are going to talk, what they are going to do, let's go around the story. In Africa, the honey guide and the honey badger are partners when it comes to honey. The little bird follows a bee to its hive and then she leads the honey badger there to break it open with its strong claws. Together, they share the sweetness. And this is the way it has always been. Here you can see that a guider and a honey catcher. Maybe this day badger was hungrier than usual. Maybe he forgot about honey guide who showed him the way. Or could he have been thinking, my strong claws do all the hard work? Whatever the reason, that day badger would not share. Honey guide scolded badger as he waddled back to the jackalberry tree, his tummy almost touching the ground. She fussed and fumed as he tried to fit into his burrow. Finally, she cried out for all the animals to hear. No fear, no fear. Soon, all the guinea hens were broadcasting the news. Honey guide is in a major rage. But badger didn't hear. He was sound asleep, smiling, snoring, hiccuping from his big meal. Grrrm. Badger roared out the loudest hiccup of all, and its deep, low rumble gave honey guide an idea. The next morning, badger woke up hungry, his tummy flat as a pancake. That's when honey guide flew by, heading for the great gray bobber. Honey, 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 she cried, grinning. The little bird zigzagged over its large roots. Pitter patter. Badger ran after her. Pitter patter. Honey guide flew low across the water hole. Splish, splash. Badger paddled after her. Splish, splash. Honey guide glided to the top of a termite mound and bounced on 1 foot. Sprung! Badger scrambled to the top and bounced off. Sprung! Honey guide landed on a hollow log. It echoed as she stomped along. Boom, boom! Badger hurried to catch up. Boom, boom! Next, honey guide flitted through a stand of papyrus. Tall, dry reeds bobbed back and forth. Clickety click. Badger trapples along muttering. Where is that honey? The papyrus rattled as he went by. Clickety click. Honey guide led him through a field of golden bristle grass. Swish, swish. Badger huffed and puffed, but the thought of delicious meal waiting for him kept him going. Swish, swish. By now, Badger was tired and wet, itchy and sore, but he didn't slow down because Honey Guide was just ahead of him. She flashed her wings, fanned her tail, and dove under an acacia tree. Badger charged in after her, singing triumphantly, honey, honey. When he turned in, what he saw? Honey, honey, lion. Lion, lion, lion. Badger turned on his tail and ran. Swish, swish through the grass. Clickety click into the papyrus. Boom, boom over the hollow log. Sprung over the termite mound. Splish, splash across a water hole. Pitter patter over the bob of roots. Badger dashed into his burrow. Honey guide cheered. In a flash, badger was as far from the entrance as he could be. Right behind him was lion's huge paw, battling in the air. But he could not reach him. That's the closest any animal could be to an angry lion and live to tell the tale. That evening, mongoose quick to elephant, who trumpeted to hippo, who wallowed to warthog, who squealed to bishop bird, who piped to hyena, who whooped to zebra, who snorted to giraffe, who was overheard by guinea hen, who buggled it far and wide. It was the bush telegraph, and it said, if honey guide leads you to a beehive, be sure and reward her, or next time she will lead you to a lion.